spent the better part of my life following the lust of motorsport, both excited by it and in wonderment of why people might do the same. What makes this sport, this passion, so invigorating? Yeah, motorsports is a wonderful hotbed of innovation, but at its core, it serves no real purpose. What good does it do for the world if somebody takes their specific vehicle around a track 2/100ths of a second faster than somebody else? My point being, the only societal benefit that exists, besides the unintended technical innovations, is an egotistical one. To win. To be the best. To have a purpose. I thought I understood what this meant, to have a purpose, but this whole road to champ car endeavor exists to confirm what I thought I knew about motorsport. I have been fortunate in my engineering career to drive many six-figure cars for countless hours, and I thought I knew what focus was. Some were focused on technical achievements and hybrid development. Some were focused on speed. But the common denominator is how compromised each vehicle was. This vehicle, who I referred to as Elizabeth, is by no means a perfect racing car. But it is focused. It is purely focused on one thing and one thing only. No compromises. And with that focus comes an inherent purpose. A creating one's path to destiny, if you will. Not destiny, but path to destiny. Creating a road to travel down. And that, I suppose, is the crux of this thesis, I guess. I have wondered frequently on what my purpose is in this life. But the human condition, like motorsport, might not have an inherent purpose. But this doesn't mean we can't have a purpose. Just that your non-compromised focus has to determine it. So whatever that is, it's up to you to make the choice. Thanks for watching, y'all. I know this was a different style of video today and much more philosophical than normal, but I appreciate you taking the time to watch it. If you enjoyed it, then please feel free to stick around and watch more videos and maybe even subscribe so you can stay up to date on new content. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one.